How many times happened that when we try to sublimate caps for the first time, paper get wrinkled due to excessive pressure, or the fabric became yellow? Today I will show you how to sublimate caps, and it will be a design that will be centered on our cap. So let's go to the video. Hello colleagues, welcome to my YouTube channel Sublimonchis. I am graduating in Visual Design and Communication Ramon Arroyo, Sublimonchis for colleagues, and today I'm going to show you step by step how to sublimate caps, so you can have a good results and don't get through the problems that I had when I was starting in this of the sublimation caps. Something that really caused me enough trouble because there are details that should be taken into account and not everybody tells you. I'm going to show you here so that you will get good results. We are going to place a circular design that is going to be centered on our cap. It's not a very broad design, but they also cause problems. Today I'm going to show you the process for do it, and you will get a good printing at the time of sublimation. Later in another video we will sublimate a larger area that is causing much more problems, but we will start with this one, so that you will get into printing trucker caps by sublimation. I am using a special editor to type heat press for caps. It is ColorMic brand and has a good unit for heating. It's what will help us to have a good result at the time of sublimating our caps. When closing, it begins to discount the time that has been programmed. At the end, an alarm will sound when our cap is ready. Here we have our heat press ready to sublimate. The heat press has an alligator opening and it is easy to use. This makes printing much easier. Another detail we must take into account is that it has a handle at the bottom to stretch our trucker cap, and it will get completely flat so that our impression is not going to get crumpled lines left in our cap. Anyway, here on the screen I'm going to show you one of the first caps I made. You can see the problems can be caused at the time of wrinkled paper and bad result caused when we start. Sometimes we don't realize why this problem is happening. Well, let's go to the process of sublimation over caps. Parameters that we are going to use is 190 degrees centigrade for 20 seconds. As always, we have our impression in mirror mode with special inks for sublimation, as well as special paper for sublimation. We have it ready and it's going to be centered in our cap. First of all, we need to remove the cardboard inside caps. Second thing we have to do is warm up our neoprene base, so that can adapt better to our base, and so paper makes good contact with the surface of the cap. The alarm already whistled, and now we are going to pick it up, and then we are going to wait for a little, and now we are going to place the... What we can do if you don't have a good grip, you can close your cap a bit more. Here you can see it so that our lever can hold and stretch it as much as possible. We are going to separate this to get good contact of the paper with our cap. We place it and we try to stretch as best as we can. And see our lever makes good grip, then we can adapt it and it could be stretched much better. Be careful that this visor doesn't touch with this because it can be burned. We bend it a little and place it in our base. Now what we're going to do is to close our heat press very gently to give a warm up, also over front part of the cap. That will make it flatter so it doesn't cause wrinkles in the paper and sticks very well, and has very good contact paper with the fabric of the cap. It's going to be very soft around 5 seconds. Now we're going to place the paper directly centered on our cap, quickly so that it takes advantage of heat and adapt to our cap. There are times that you can place thermal tape to place it and keep it in place, but I will not use because with this method paper adapts very well. Now, next step is very important. You must close the heat press smoothly. First movements are light. Now you release and press it. Now we're going to wait for the seconds and moment of lifting. It's going to be also very gently, so that it won't rise so abruptly. I want you to see that the paper was not folded and has released a good amount of ink. Well, Sublimongeros, this is how you should print a cap with only 20 seconds to 190 Celsius degrees, and let's see the result. Here we have it ready in full color, what you can see when you release a good amount of ink from paper. It's black color. That's where you can see if you get problems with colors. When you're printing black color, that is when you will realize that your sublimation ink doesn't have a good quality. Here is it, we already have it completely ready. Well, colleagues, I hope you find this video useful. Something very important that you should take into account is that if you don't appear warm as I showed in the first printing, you will get your paper wrinkled. Be careful enough and don't ruin a cap. Anyway, I hope this video will be useful when you start doing your test and have bigger chance to get good results. And so far we leave this video. Visit sublimonches.com to download some free templates to sublimate. Leave your like and subscribe to your channel, and those who already subscribe, activate the notifications on the bell. So when we upload the video, if you activate the notification bell, you will be notified when we have a new video. So you can learn a lot, and there is nothing left to say. See you in the next video, and let's sublimate.